Welcome to an overview of the Salt River Biodiversity Project. We will take a field trip today to some of the study reaches and introduce our methods and some interesting biota that we have in this area. The reaches we will visit on the field trip are representative of the different types of areas that we sample. They vary in flow and levels of urbanization. These variables help to explain some of the differences we have observed in the long-term data sets on birds and herpetofauna, which are reptiles and amphibians. Phoenix has developed around several rivers, including the Salt. Locally, we refer to Phoenix as the Valley because there are several rivers that flow through the area, the Salt, the Verde, and the Gila rivers, for example. The Salt has several water impoundments and diversions, and flow through the city can be intermittent, and there are some dry reaches as well. The river flows through the area from east to west, and we have 7 study reaches with multiple subsamples within those reaches, and today we're going to visit 3 of them. The first site on our field trip will be to the Tonto Reach, early morning at dawn. This is located on the Tonto National Forest and serves as a non-urban reach with native riparian woody vegetation, and this area has permanent flows, it has high bird biodiversity, and it has the highest diversity of reptiles and amphibians. Good morning and welcome to the Salt River. My name is Heather Bateman and I'm one of the co-leads for the Parks and Rivers IRT. And today we're at Tonto. We're on a Tonto National Forest, and this is our non-urban site along the Salt River. And this is a nice example of riparian or floodplain habitats. This is a really diverse ecosystem. We have tall trees like cottonwoods, and the vegetation changes in very predictable ways as you move away from the stream. The groundwater gets deeper and the vegetation starts to change from cottonwood and willow to more mesquite woodlands, and then you have upland Sonoran desert. So thanks for joining us. We sample the bird community at 6 point count stations per reach. Each station is a 50 meter fixed radius, and the point count lasts for 15 minutes, and it's done by a trained observer like Kristen Godbeer. We also do these surveys seasonally. The Tonto site has many different recreational users. We have hikers, horseback riders, we have feral horses, there are kayakers and tubers, and some of the biota that's interesting here occurs along certainly the Gallery Cottonwood Forest area, and then also the cliffs. They're home to birds of prey and swallows, and we see some of the same species utilizing urban structures in some of our reaches downstream, such as bridges and overpasses. So this is a ornate tree lizard. It's a male, Urosaurus ornatus. They do really well with vertical habitat, and so in this riparian area, they are on cottonwood trees, but in urban areas, they're pretty common using cinder block walls and the infrastructure in our urban system. So this is a species that does well in the city and outside of the city. Downstream, we have the Price Reach. And this is an interesting area because it has perennial flows and it includes a culvert that carries water from the surrounding urban landscape. So this is considered a wet reach and an accidental wetland because although it has not undergone restoration management efforts, vegetation has responded to the input of these flows. This area harbors high plant and bird biodiversity. Just downstream of this area is Tempe Town Lake. The second stop on our field trip will be to the Rio Salado area. This is the Rio Reach. And this area has undergone extensive engineering to stabilize the channel, add terracing, and planting native cottonwood trees. The site has perennial flows
And the surrounding land use is urban here. This area supports high plant biodiversity and bird communities.
So we're overlooking the Salt River, and this is the Rio site, very close to downtown Phoenix. So the surrounding land use here is a much greater degree of urbanization than, say, the Tonto. We're close to a major airport, Sky Harbor, and this is a nice view of showing how much vegetation is on this site. Our sites do vary in degree of hydrology, so we have wet sites and dry sites. This is obviously a wet site, and it's also a site that's been purposefully restored, and the channel has been modified, and cottonwood trees have been planted. So here's an example of how we survey for herpetofauna, reptiles and amphibians. And we're mostly looking for diurnal species and flushing them. And observers work in pairs ordinarily. And sometimes they lift some debris. This can be cover for organisms underneath. And we've found some interesting species here in the middle of Phoenix. Western diamondback rattlesnakes are probably among the most common snake species. We also have Sonoran gopher snakes and California king snakes. For amphibians, we have toads once in a while, like woodhouse toad. And in the waters, we have some non-native and invasive species, American bullfrog. Some sites have inputs from the surrounding urban area, and that water comes through drains, such as the one you see here. Several of the species of birds in our non-urban reaches also occur within the city, and they're utilizing structures such as overpasses for nesting. So we have great horned owls and cliff swallows that are in these reaches as well. The last stop on our field trip is going to be to a dry reach, 35th Avenue. Here we are along the Salt River. This study reach is 35th Avenue, and we consider this a dry reach. Sometimes there is flow in the river if there's a heavy precipitation event or if there's dam releases, but for the most part, it is dry. We also have some inputs from urban drains that come into the channel, and that does support some vegetation. The surrounding urban land use here is quite industrial. Overall, we've seen some interesting patterns with our long-term data sets. Bird communities from urban riparian areas are losing ground, and they've declined by 26% over the past 16 years. Along the Salt River and other riparian areas, bird diversity is driven by levels of urbanization and amount of perennial flow. We have greater bird diversity at low levels of urbanization within the dry reaches and greater diversity at intermediate levels of urbanization at the wet reaches. Thanks for joining our field trip today.